So we've just seen an alternative representation of using Bayes' rule. And for those of you who've seen Bayes' rule before, I just wanted to sort of draw the connections to what I've just showed you with kind of the traditional framework for writing down Bayes' rule. So anytime we have a joint probability, in this case the probability of A and B, this can be rewritten using conditional probabilities. So the probability of A and B is the probability of A times the probability of B given A. And this will always hold regardless of whether or not A or B are independent. And by symmetry, I can write this as the reverse. This is also equal to the probability of B times the probability of A given B. Okay? So if I actually wanted to solve for something, say the probability of A given B, I can just rearrange these terms. So the probability of A given B equals the probability of A times the probability of B given A divided by the probability of B. And this is sort of this standard formula that many probability textbooks will have on Bayes' rule. So how does this relate to what we just did? Well, I can actually draw these same probabilities using decision trees. So in this case, again, I have two branches. This first branch would correspond to the probability of A, and this second branch would correspond to the probability of B given A. And the value at the end of the tree is then the probability of both A and B. Okay? When I flip the tree, we again go through the same steps so that the probability at the end of the tree is the same, the probability of A and B. And now this becomes the probability of B and the probability of A given B. So in the example that I just went through, we could think of probability of A as the probability of a disease, and B is the probability of a positive test result. And what we're actually interested in is the probability of the disease given a positive test result. So conceptually, doing a tree flipping exercise is exactly the same as doing Bayes' rule, sort of using the more standard notation that you see here. So just to recap what we've discussed today, Bayes' rule is an effective tool for updating our probabilistic beliefs. So in particular, in medicine, Bayes' rule can be used to update the probability beliefs that a person has a particular disease given a particular test result. So we saw in the United States, given a background prevalence level of 1% of the population and a test with 99.1% sensitivity and 99.6% specificity, we saw that a person only has a 71% chance of having HIV given a positive test result. So we're updating our beliefs. We previously thought it was a 1% probability, then we observe a test result, and then we conclude, or we update our probability beliefs to 72% probability. The second key takeaway is that both the background prevalence level as well as sensitivity and specificity of the test influence these probability beliefs. So in particular, we saw that in South Africa, where we have 40% HIV prevalence, after observing a positive test result, we update this belief to over 99% probability. So again, the prevalence as well as the sensitivity and specificity of the test drive these results. And thirdly, we showed that with HIV testing, what often occurs is a sequence of tests. So we do a preliminary test, either a rapid test or another HIV test. And because that first test casts a very wide net, meaning that it finds almost everyone who has HIV, as well as a few extra people who are diagnosed as false positives, we then want to perform a second test that has a high specificity so that we can then rule out everyone who has a false positive test. And we can use Bayes' rule to actually estimate the overall sensitivity and specificity of such a testing algorithm.